tunnel like a football team. He's got that kind of mentality, and there's plenty of running room here in this venue. It's the open field of the Grand Ballroom. He's got people like Jimmy Thunder, Tony Tucker, Carl the Truth Williams on his hit list, but more recently, Jerry Ballard, Mario Pauly, Fernley Feliz, and Tom Williams. Not exactly household names, looking to erase the embarrassment of the 19-second KO loss to Tua in 96. He's 11-0 with 10 knockouts since, KO'd the last six. But I'll tell you, Bobby, the one previous time Ruiz stepped up in opposition, he was obliterated by Tua. Why should we think it won't happen again? Perhaps not as emphatically. And how can we truly tell how improved he is since based on his level of opposition?
Well, for starters, Holyfield is not the puncher that Tua is. Tua is 240-plus pounds. Ruiz is not giving away that kind of weight. Ruiz has the age factor on his side. And again, Holyfield's not a big puncher. Styles make fights. And I'll tell you what, in this fight, if Ruiz can hold his own for the first few rounds, he can set it up. And what he needs to do is really step up, or the ghost of David Tua will continue to haunt him.
And here is Evander the Real Deal Holyfield. Brave, legendary champion. Classic overachiever. That could be detrimental to his health. He says he's stronger, but not as quick. The always spiritual Evander Holyfield hearing it from the crowd. Three-time heavyweight champion, inactive about 10 months. Making the long walk to the ring. Of many fans, the media, is this a catch-22? I mean, if Holyfield wins, people will say he was fed the title on a silver platter. If Ruiz wins, it's because Holyfield is shot. Is that a fair assessment?
Well, in many people's eyes, Steve, that's going to be a fair assessment, but Lennox Lewis didn't defend against Ruiz, and he was supposed to, so that title becomes up for grabs because he was, the judge made him relinquish it. Now, John Ruiz can lay claim to being in a position here by his ranking. Evander Holyfield was just beaten by Lewis twice, so that just doesn't make sense.
We've seen evidence of ring erosion and deterioration. One more question. How many times can Holyfield go to the well and come up big?
You know, Steve, only really Evander Holyfield, his doctor, his trainer, and his people, his handlers, they know. They know what they've seen in the gym. He knows what he feels on the inside. Some people can do it. George Foreman took over a decade, came back, and dug deep and found water.
All right, we size them up. Let's go to the tail of the tape. The biggest disparity in age, Holyfield nearly a decade older than Ruiz, almost exactly the same height, reaches even. Holyfield career heaviest, 221, 224 for Ruiz, down 7 from his last fight. And the key rules for this WBA title fight, no standing 8 count, no 3 knockdown rule. The fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round. If an accidental headbutt occurs before the end of the fourth, it's ruled a no contest. If it happens after the end of round 4, they go to the scorecard. So here at the Grand Ballroom in Las Vegas, getting ready for our main event. Looks like a sellout crowd of around 9,000 on hand for Holyfield Ruiz, vacant WBA heavyweight title. The official introductions from our ring announcer, the classy Jimmy Glennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to Paris, Las Vegas, Resort and Casino in Las Vegas, Nevada, as it's time for our featured bout of the evening, brought to you by Don King Productions in association with Showtime Championship Boxing, Paris, Las Vegas, and Budweiser, the undisputed king of beers. This bout coming away is sanctioned by the World Boxing Association, the president Gilberto Mendoza, supervisor Carlos Chavez, along with the Nevada State Athletic Commission. The chairman is Dr. Elias Ghanem, commissioners Amy Ayub, Glenn Carano, Dr. Flip Pomansky, and Dr. Luther Mack. The executive director is Mark Ratner. Our three judges scoring this bout from ringside, from Las Vegas, Nevada, Dwayne Ford. Also from Las Vegas, Dave Moretti. And from La Valencia, Venezuela, Fernando Viso. And introducing the third man of the ring, our referee in charge of this bout, Richard Steele. All right, fans, here we go with our main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the vacant WBA Heavyweight Championship of the World. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance, and boxing fans joining us around the world, live from Paris, Las Vegas, it's showtime! Introducing to you first, ladies and gentlemen, on my right, fighting out of the blue corner, ready to fight, wearing black trunks, hailing from Chelsea, Massachusetts, by way of Sabana Grande, Puerto Rico. His weight, 224 pounds. His record stands at 36 wins, 3 losses, with 27 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, he is making his first bid for a world title, also attempting to become the very first Latino heavyweight world champion, introducing the WBA number one ranked heavyweight contender, known as the Quiet Man. Here is John Ruiz. And his opponent across the ring, on my left, fighting out of the red corner, really needing no introduction the world over, wearing red trunks with silver trim, fighting out of and representing his hometown of Atlanta, Georgia. He weighed in at 221 pounds with a record of 36 wins, 4 losses and 1 draw. He has 25 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, he makes an historic bid to become the first man to win a heavyweight title 4 times. Here is the former undisputed cruiserweight world champion, the former undisputed heavyweight world champion, and the current WBA number 2 ranked heavyweight in the world. Please welcome one of boxing's great warriors, introducing Evander, the real deal. Once again, a referee in charge, Richard Steele, now to give instructions, 12 rounds of championship boxing schedule.
Okay, you guys, I spoke to both of you in your dressing room. I'm cautioning again, obey my commands at all time. I see both of your labels, so that's great. Anything below will be a low blow, okay? Any questions? Shake hands and good luck.
You can make an argument Holyfield's offense was better and busier his last fight, the rematch with Lennox Lewis. Which Holyfield will we see tonight? A more active, aggressive one, or a slower, less energetic one? John Ruiz, look at, he's ready to pounce out. Usually starts fast, aggressive, straight ahead fighter, not much side to side, has power, best weapon, left hook, right uppercut combination. Here we go.
Steve, the first two rounds of this fight is the monster. The guy that sets the tone, as Ruiz is trying to do, gets the play.
Ruiz immediately digging to the ribs of Holyfield.
No warning. Break. Step back.
Ruiz did come out fast. Ruiz sticking the jab, landing the rights and lefts, going to the body.
Ruiz is working that right hand to the body an awful lot very early.
He said he needed to throw a barrage to smother Holyfield with combinations. But the key to establish the jab.
He said he had to watch out for Holyfield's left hook, and Holyfield right now is just letting him get that energy out, letting Ruiz work early and trying to gauge him. I think gauge his strength, gauge his power, gauge his speed, and you're going to see a burst from Holyfield. I know you will.
Ruiz immediately testing the previously damaged left rib cage of Holyfield.
No, Holy!
Whoa! And Holyfield, with some wrestling tactics, just throwing, spinning Ruiz away into the corner. Holyfield feels he hasn't lost anything as far as strength, but perhaps in his quickness. Now Holyfield coming back with hard left uppercuts.
Come on, pull your arms back.
To the
pull them back. Pull them back, Vandam. Great, step back, step back.
Vandam job for Richard Steele. Ruiz doing a nice job with that left jab, looking to set up the overhand right.
Holyfield right now looking a little bit slow. No real snap to his punches, and not throwing many at all, Steve.
Well, Ruiz looking to get out. The early right, respect somebody. Of Evander Holyfield, and it seems like it's working.
Well, I know he's got his attention because he's in his face every second.
Here's that good shotgun jab again, right in the head by Ruiz. Ruiz with a snappy left hook, follows it up with a right hand, and again continues to score.
The jab is working perfectly for John Ruiz. He's not only getting in with the jab, closing the gap, getting inside, he's scoring with it.
And the fans.
Punch it out! Punch it out!
Holyfield.
Right, step back, step back.
Ruiz winning round one. Scoring effectively. Left hook there to the jaw. Short, snappy punches by Ruiz. For the relatively unknown John Ruiz.
You gotta use your jab more.
You gotta match your jab.
It's gonna be a very physical fight early on, a lot of wrestling. This is an attrition type match. Tangling arms, holding on the inside. Evander tying up Ruiz, and it's not the cleanest of clinches. Watch the jab of Ruiz. One, two. Those two weren't the two most effective ones, but he comes back. Three. And landing. Holyfield offering up nothing. There's a hook. Another jab, a double jab. Ready to set up the right hand. He's constantly working in, pushing Holyfield back. Holyfield's power is significantly lessened when he's moving backward. He can't jump in with that 221 pounds.
Round one, reminiscent of the Holyfield Vaughn Bean fight. Round two begins. And Ruiz again comes out in aggressive fashion. Part of Ruiz's strategy in round one was to back Holyfield up into the ropes with that effective jab, or by force if he had to. And Ruiz got the job done.
Holyfield's working more. Coming, throwing the punches much more readily now.
Straight right hand to the head by Holyfield. An overhand right by John Ruiz. Ruiz jumping on Holyfield and again backing him into the ropes.
Step back, step back.
Again, a jab. He's got that jab in Holyfield's face. Holyfield can't lead with those big hooks when he's got a jab in his face.
You know, they're cheering in Chelsea right now.
Keep him in front.
It's been nearly non-stop action since the opening bell. Not many lulls. Now Holyfield goes to the double up of the jab. Ruiz has answers for just about everything, Bobby.
Well, you know, he's prepared for this fight. This is his whole lifetime. And again, that ghost of David Tua is haunting him. And it's really, there's a shove to the ground. Not a punch, just kind of threw him to the ground.
Don't push him.
No knockdown. Holyfield holding and pushing. That's why Ruiz went down. And he gets cautioned by Richard Steele.
Ruiz stopped working that right hand to the body. First round was very effective.
Nice right uppercut to the jaw by Ruiz. And that snapped Holyfield's head back. And then he sticks that stiff left jab in on the face of Holyfield.
Punch your way out. Don't hold him.
This is a very physical fight. Tough. Keep your body right and everything correct. Wrestling, pulling on arms.
Don't spin it.
Grabbing, pulling on shoulders. Very, very wear and tear type fight.
Ruiz, like an octopus all over Holyfield. Hasn't let up. A lot of pressure. There's a big right hand by John Ruiz.
There's a nice body combination here by Holyfield that seemed to slow John down just a little bit.
Punch away out. Come on.
He's still coming forward.
Pull him back. Right. Step back. Step back.
Ruiz, very democratic, mixing it up, going to the head and body. Well, he certainly got the attention of the former undisputed champion, Evander Holyfield. There's that great jab again by Ruiz.
It was a nice counter attempt by Ruiz. He rocked on Holyfield's jab, tried to fire a right hand, but it was off the target.
Come on, you got to work.
That is really an effective jab by John Ruiz. It's pushing Holyfield back, and it's also setting up the right hand.
Come on, punch away out.
Ruiz's strategy, just lie on top of Holyfield, put his weight on him, weigh him down.
Stand up. Okay, sit down.
Vaseline.
All right, my man. Johnny, listen, you got to work the jab a little more. You understand? You're making this a walk for yourself. You don't need it. You don't need it, Johnny. Come on.
John Ruiz trying to draw some fire from Holyfield. Counter, that left hook was low. Right hand over the top didn't land too well. Trying to draw Holyfield's firing. There's a left hook to the body and a right hand which lands very cleanly on the jaw of Holyfield. The look in Holyfield's eyes is not what it usually is. I can tell you, something's off. Here's another look at John Ruiz coming in underneath. Throws the hook up top and the right hand over the top. Working that body, trying to stay on it. Keeping Holyfield on his heels, a very smart tech. Here we see it from the overhead and the pull down, slip pull down combination there.
Ruiz said he definitely had to win the first three rounds. That's what he told us the other day. And if he wins this fight, he said it'll have to be by knockout or decisive decision. The judges won't give him a close decision.
I believe that's probably correct. I think that if this fight is close, they give it to Holyfield because Holyfield Tyson 3 is worth more money than any other fight out there right now.
And you wonder, as Ruiz lands again off the top of Holyfield's head with the overhand right, if Holyfield gets too frustrated, it will start the elbows and the forearms and the head.
Punch your way out.
He's been known to do that.
Pull him back.
Ruiz injured his left hand a couple of months ago in a kitchen accident. He cut a tendon, but said it's a non-factor. Certainly no sign of it there with that left hook.
Nice counter left hook by John Ruiz, landing off the top of Holyfield's head, but he needs to follow up the second shot, and a right hand like that.
Oh, there's a right uppercut out of nowhere by Holyfield to the chin of Ruiz. Slows him down momentarily, but then he comes back. Wild swing and a miss by Evander. Oh, got a straight right hand to the nose by Ruiz. What an exchange. As if John Ruiz is following your keys to victory to the team.
Well, you know, Steve, some of the things I think are pretty evident. With his style, he needs to do certain things. With the Evander style, he needs to compromise and neutralize certain things. And right now, he's doing a very good job of it.
Now Holyfield working to the jab. Ruiz just falls down.
Don't hold him.
Again, the blame on Holyfield for pushing him down for the hold. Well, that looked like sheer exhaustion.
Beautiful uppercut by Holyfield. Landed squarely on Ruiz's chin. No ill effects.
We approach the final minute of round three. Terrific action. But John Ruiz in control to this point.
Holyfield's just not working hard. One other key was outworking him, and John Ruiz is outworking him. But can he sustain his pace for the 12th full round? That's huge.
Ruiz out hustling Holyfield. Another question is, can Holyfield go 12 hard rounds if necessary? John Ruiz nearly 10 years younger than Holyfield, who turns 38 in October. Good combination of the head by Holyfield and back pain Ruiz. Oh, a straight right hand by Holyfield that stuns Ruiz.
You hurt Ruiz with that right hand.
Ruiz is wounded.
His chin is in question before.
He's in trouble. Holyfield jumps on him. Let's see if he can finish him. 14 seconds to go in the third round. The tide has turned. Ruiz hanging on.
Great. Step back.
Just
step
a few more seconds and he makes it through the round.
Boxing, Johnny. They do that shit. They don't listen to me, John. Come on now. Come on, baby. Let's see the boxing.
You gotta use your jab.
Johnny,
come on,
how
Jim.
You doing?
Good.
Come on.
Told you, John Ruiz can't stay on the outside. This is the range that's Holyfield. Watch him walk into a right hand. It's a beauty. That's not the range for John Ruiz in this fight. There's the right hand. He walks right into it over the jab. And that hurt him and it rocked him. And again, Holyfield doesn't punch like Tua, but he punches well enough. Watch his right hand. Right on the top of the temple. Ruiz holding on. You can see his legs are not under him. There is badly shaking.
Ruiz was doing a great job the first three rounds, staying close to Holyfield, scoring effectively. As soon as he gave Holyfield some distance, it was a different story. Ruiz stunned, 20 seconds left in round three. He made it to the bell, but barely.
We'll see now if John Ruiz is still hurt.
Left-right combination of the head by Holyfield. Holyfield
coming
with a
to
smile. That left jab is scoring effectively now by Evander. And Ruiz backs up, a totally different Ruiz, who has felt the power of Holyfield. Ruiz is now.
But Holy's not working him. Steve Holy should be on him. All over him. He's giving John time.
Let's see if Holyfield puts on more pressure here. There's a straight right hand that scores by Ruiz.
Ruiz turning the tide back.
Why is Holyfield taking this tactic?
Another big right hand by John Ruiz.
Holyfield had Ruiz where he wanted him, and then he lays back.
He's not working, and I don't know what's going on, but he has evidently just, he almost looks like he's disinterested to a degree. There has to be a physical problem. Again, the right hand.
Punching it out.
It's Holyfield who suddenly becomes overly cautious, and he had Ruiz in his pocket.
I'm going to tell you, Steve, exactly what it looks like. It looks exactly like the Holyfield that fought Michael Moore the first time. It looks like he's having a problem with his heart or his breathing or something. Something inside him is not working properly.
What an interesting development here in round four. Just when it looked like Holyfield had everything going for him, he stopped fighting.
Come on, work, don't hold him.
And really, there may be something wrong with him. Meanwhile, Ruiz backpedaling.
He lands right hand.
A couple of lefts after the right. That wakes up Holyfield. The stiff left jab again by Ruiz.
Don't hold him. Come on, work your way out. Break, step back.
A very bizarre fourth round.
Evander did not at any point in time during this round jump on John Ruiz to see if he had any cobwebs left. And now John Ruiz is putting some punches on him.
And I can't wait for the end of this fight to find out if there was anything wrong with Evander Holyfield. Final seconds, round four. Holyfield letting Ruiz off the hook.
Can you hold the mouth, please? Give me that Vaseline. Give me that sponge.
I'm in a sponge.
You gotta throw punches, champ. You're making all the moves, you just ain't punching.
You're gonna watch now. Evander Holyfield throws out a little bit of a lazy jab, and over the top of it comes a right hand. Lazy jab, there's a right hand. Now that one didn't land very cleanly. But I will tell you, three or four of them landed very cleanly and buckled Holyfield.
Get on. He's
Combination punches, baby. Combination punches.
Going with the rhythm, Holly.
Keep that head moving. Keep it moving.
You can do it, Holly. You can do it, baby.
Holyfield doesn't look right. He seems to be holding back on throwing the right hand.
He seems to be holding back on throwing a lot of things.
It's pretty early and pretty unusual in a heavyweight title fight to take off a fourth round.
Especially when you have your guy down, well, not down, but almost down in the previous round and in serious trouble.
Is this the night that Evander Holyfield finally gets old?
John Ruiz now staying on the outside, not a good place for him. He needs to be working behind that jab.
He nailed him with the right, missed wildly with the left, Ruiz. Holyfield taking off just about the complete fourth round.
Beautiful jab by John Ruiz.
It was.
He stuffed the shotgun jab, turning the jaw of Evander Holyfield.
And he's been doing that with regularity. So far, number one is ahead of number two, surprisingly.
Work out.
Ruiz does like the jab to the body, sometimes a dangerous move. Counter right hands over the top. We saw Holyfield rock him with one before, but he's still throwing to that body.
Punch! Punch and get out! Punch and get out, guys! Come on!
Holyfield eating a lot of leather. Combination to the head. Holyfield looks exhausted.
He looks exhausted. He looks like he's having a problem. There's a physical problem, Steve. There has to be. This is a specimen that we have seen summoning it up time after time. In later rounds, in longer, harder fights, something's wrong.
And he's not fighting Lennox Lewis or David Tua or Mike Tyson. He's fighting a relatively unknown John Ruiz, who will be very known if he wins this fight.
Right, right.
Again, Ruiz sticking that left jab to the chin of Holyfield.
But he's only throwing one, Steve. What he needs to do is throw a double, triple jab and then fire the right hand over the top.
Like that.
There's a nice double jab and no right hand.
What do you want, everything?
I do.
There's a right uppercut on the inside by Holyfield. Ruiz ties Evander up.
Come on, punch and get out.
John's out working, but he's not doing a lot. And Holyfield's just doing less.
Break, step back, step back.
A lot of holding and clutching going on right now. Right uppercut, a grazing blow by Ruiz. There's a straight right hand to the head of Holyfield. That was a blistering shot by the Quiet Man.
Holyfield going to try and steal around here, but it's too late.
Big finish for John Ruiz.
You don't have to slug with this guy. To your right! Fuck the crowd!
Get in the water, get in the water.
That's it. I'm
gonna watch the jab. John Ruiz doubles that jab up, fires that jab. Before Holyfield can do anything. There's that shotgun jab we're talking about. Stuffs it before Holyfield can do much. On the inside, he tries to get an uppercut in the air. But that's the jab that's been winning the round so far.
Come on, babe.
And when he hits you, hit him right back. Hit him right back immediately.
Let's go. Come on. Right back. Right back.
Yes.
It sometimes takes an extraordinary circumstance to bring out the best in Evander Holyfield. We described John Ruiz as a good guy earlier. Perhaps he doesn't want to antagonize the former champion too much. Just kidding. Round six underway. Holyfield just seems to be out of it.
We talked about him being the ultimate overachiever. Sometimes overachievers, by their nature of the game, just will not look at their health first.
Ruiz just walked into a left hook on the temple by Holyfield.
He shook that one off much better though, Steve. No wobbling, no bad legs.
The end of round three, he was really shaken up, Ruiz. Beautiful right by Holyfield. But Holyfield couldn't finish him off. And then he took off the whole round four for some reason. We're not sure. It does seem like there may be something wrong with him. Again, stuffing that jab is Ruiz. Richard Steele calls time.
On the field.
There's some loose tape on the left glove of Ruiz. Mark Ratner, the head of the commission, tells us it's the first time in Nevada he's allowed fighters to wear different colored gloves, as you've noticed.
The band are wearing designer gloves.
Color coordinated to match.
Both made by Grant, though. It's the same glove, just in different colors.
Time in. Round six continues. The crowd trying to get behind Holyfield by chanting Holy in unison. Left hook off the head by Holyfield.
Punching it out.
I think a left hook on the inside hurt John Ruiz a little bit.
And then bullying tactics by Ruiz.
What he's trying to do is stay inside the power shots.
Jim Gray spoke with Don Turner, Holyfield's trainer, a moment ago. And Turner told Jim there's nothing wrong with Evander.
Wow. You couldn't fight a Lennox Lewis, a David Tua, even a lesser fighter right now would give Holyfield all he wants. He just doesn't seem to have what it takes today.
Right off the top of the head, glancing blow by John Ruiz. He's got to get that one just a tad lower.
There's that jab again in the right hand.
He just stuffs it.
Another 1-2.
Punching it out. Come on, your hands are free. No push. Right, step back.
Here's a cut around the right eye of John Ruiz.
Keep him up. No Holy.
I'll tell you, I'd be willing to bet that came from heads clashing on the inside because Holy hasn't landed good clean shots other than the one in the second round or third round, excuse me, and big right hand was on the button.
Break, step back. Keep him in front.
John Ruiz showing his grit and his toughness.
You're not busy enough, Holy.
You're losing every round, champ. You won one round. You understand that? Because you're white. This guy's bluffing you with that right hand. He's hitting you with it every once in a while, but it's because you're waiting back on him. You got to boogie up. You got to get up there quick. Then work. Get up there quick. Work behind the jab. Get up there quick. Let your hands go. Come on, babe. Come on now.
Man, combination. That's all you need to do. Combination. Everything. Tony, you gotta move. You gotta move, buddy. Hold it. Hold it, power, dude. Come on, champ.
Run
your champ and suck it up. Let's go. Suck
Johnny,
it up.
Just
suck it up. Go. Come on.
Just move.
Suck it up, John.
Just move.
Come on. Suck it up. Go. Come on.
Your move.
Go. Your move.
Blood first appeared under the right eye of John Ruiz halfway through round six. They were being very blunt in the Holyfield corner, telling the former champ that he won only one round thus far.
Well, that's how I have it, too. Five rounds to one. And his corner's being incredibly honest with him.
Online, the folks have Ruiz ahead. Four rounds to two. They give Holyfield rounds three and six.
Big right hand there by Ruiz. But again, he has stopped the pressure. He's stopped the pace. One big shot, and then he's holding.
Right uppercut by Holyfield, going back to the jab, missing with the overhand right. Ruiz sticking a straight left hand to the head of Holyfield.
Come on, you guys, break!
It's getting to the point where they separate, Ruiz steps in with a big jab, they hold. And it's a repeating set of sequences. There it is, again.
Punching it out!
Ruiz came out blazing.
Watch your head.
I believe some of the adrenaline has disappeared from John Ruiz early in the fight, especially the very beginning. It's tiring a little bit. Some of the event has gotten to him, as well as that fast pace he put on.
Holyfield doing a nice job blocking punches. He is pressing the attack, pushing Ruiz off of him, and digging to the body and wrapping his left hook around the head of Ruiz. Here's that shotgun jab by Ruiz again. One and done. Let's see if he offers up the right hand behind
it. Come on, work it out. Work it out.
John's landed some pretty good right hands, but jab, jab, right hand. That's it. No hook, no uppercuts. No second right hand.
There it is.
But that's it, and he holds. No need. He landed clean. Finish it up.
Break. Step back, please.
You know, he's winning the rounds by a little bit doing that, but he could be so much more convincing because Evander's not doing enough.
Ruiz now fighting in spurts. There's a big left hand by Holyfield off the chin of John Ruiz. Well, he's got a better jaw than I thought, Ruiz.
You got a nice left hook there. Holy's starting to come on, but it's late in the round. He's got to close it out if he's going to win this round.
Good counter punching by Holyfield.
One of those shots might have been a little on the low side, as was that one.
Look out again. The WWF tactics by Holyfield as he just shoves Ruiz to the canvas.
Let's go.
John Ruiz is getting
the
tired.
Second time, okay? Second warning.
Final seconds, round seven. An exhausted Ruiz lands
big
with
a left hook.
And then a right hand at the bell. Ruiz fighting on.
Breathe.
Give it up.
Nice job. Johnny, please move. Please move on this guy.
Nice
jab
back.
And move. Jab and move.
Keep it on.
Show a nice sequence. Evander throwing a jab in the right hand, and he works on a big left hook. He finished it off. That's his big power shot. And even Ruiz said he's got to stay away from that big left hook. There he follows back with an uppercut on the inside. One of the better sequences. Here's the slip slash toss to the ground. Holyfield just kind of throws them over. WWF type move.
Dramatic stuff from trainer Norm Stone in the corner of John Ruiz. Pleading for the quiet man to move more. Jab and move. Let's see if he adheres to those instructions.
Well, the jab was working in the first part of the fight. And Holyfield's coming out now to fire. He's landing big.
Holyfield jumping on Ruiz to begin round eight. Scheduled for 12 for the vacant WBA Heavyweight Championship.
Nice counter right hand by Ruiz, but he doesn't have the steam on it he had.
Holyfield with more of a purpose here. Yeah, especially with the left. A counter right hand by Ruiz.
And another one.
What an exchange. Suddenly, the crowd gets behind him.
But the energy level, Steve, it doesn't seem to be there.
Keep it clean.
That and his trunks are falling down very low.
It is waning. He started out strong and then petered out.
Punch it out of there. Come on, you got a break. Step back.
As we said before, this title may not mean
on,
a lot to a lot
out,
of people,
break, step back,
but as
step
you
back.
Can see by this
front,
demonstration of the ring, it means a heck of a lot to these two fighters.
Holy started out the round with some nice combinations, and then he just stopped. There's a nice right hand left hook, but he too is only throwing one and two at a time. The round's half over, no one's taking any real play here.
Holyfield dictating the tempo here in round eight.
You're holding, John. Let him go.
Ruiz holding on the inside. Holyfield squirms away.
Oh, he's looking at a nice left hook by John Ruiz. You can see Holy looking to set him, but his reflexes aren't reacting quick enough, and he's just a step behind where he needs to be.
Nice right uppercut to the stomach by Holyfield. There's that left jab landing by Ruiz.
Don't hold it.
but he has a bad habit of holding Holyfield after the punch.
No real meaningful punches in that combination.
Great, stop that.
Always throwing them, but he's not throwing them with bad intentions.
Beautiful left-right combination by Ruiz, a countering right hand by Holyfield.
He threw another right hand, too. Ruiz tried to throw a big left hook, missed badly.
Break! Step back, let him go.
A quick but furious exchange. Big right hand by Ruiz. To the jaw of Holyfield.
You gotta move. Make him chase you now. Make him chase you. Come on, we're in our rounds now.
That right hand's not doing it. There's not two on the
He's other trying to counter you all the time with that right hand over the top. You gotta move away.
The Warrior trying to dig down and find what he needs to win. Coming back, rocking. He still has the experience, still knows what to do. It just seems his body can't do it. There, twice trying to rock. And John Ruiz missing badly with that wild left hook. There you see again, he's trying to rock and roll. Rock on that right hand and roll back in with his own. Twice he tries it, but again, he's just a step behind in timing.
In the past, Holyfield always knew how to make the proper adjustments during the fight. He would find a way to win, as Bobby put it, dig down deep. We'll see what happens here. We are into round 9, scheduled for 12 for the vacant WBA heavyweight title.
Evander's just not doing enough to win the rounds. Even though John's not winning the rounds big, he's outworking it fully, and he's just not. There you see, jabs his way in, lands a few things, they tie up. And again, it becomes a repeat of the same sequence. Jabs in, they tie up.
Holyfield has come on recently here in this fight. How do you have it unofficially scored right now?
Unofficially, I've only given Holy one round. And maybe there's maybe another round there that was close enough to give him, but I just don't see it. He's not working. His punches sometimes are a little bigger, but not enough of them. They're not landing as clean. He's missing the mark. I mean, it's a shame to watch this. The fight is actually boring. It's a heavyweight world championship. That should never be an adjective describing that type of fight.
Step back.
We talked about the ring erosion, the possible deterioration. Holyfield nearing age 30. Again, a problem with the tape around the glove of Ruiz.
Get both of them again.
Gabe LaMarca, his trainer, wrapping the tape around.
Okay.
Holyfield could be on his way to not having won in 3 consecutive fights.
That would be unusual for this great warrior.
But he said, if necessary, he'll fight until he's 50 years old to win an undisputed heavyweight title again. Right hand to the head. Uppercuts to the body by John Ruiz.
John Ruiz landed some nice uppercuts and hooks and an overhand right.
And a beautiful combination to the head of Holyfield.
And Holy finally offered back one punch in return.
And even as he's backing up, Ruiz scoring with the left jab. Cut opening up again around the right eye
no
of Ruiz.
Running, no pushing. Greg,
Ruiz on the retreat, but landing effectively. Shots to the body by Holyfield. There's a big left hook, but that was partially blocked by Ruiz's forearm.
Yeah, Ruiz is covering. There's a big right hand. But what he's doing is he's firing and ducking. And Holyfield's starting to time him, and he's going to walk into a ripping right uppercut.
Ruiz with a sudden burst of energy here in late round 9.
Keep it clean. Right, somebody. Keep it clean, you guys. Keep it clean.
sticking the jab overhand right that scores by Ruiz at the bell. Big finish in the round for John Ruiz. Let's substantiate what Bobby was talking about as we go inside the ropes.
Well, Steve, over and over again, we watch John Ruiz work his way in, throw a nice combination, come in behind the jab, throw a few more and stop. Holy not offering much back. There's one. But in each one of these sequences, it's John Ruiz initiating and firing. Here we see it again, big jab. Over and over and over, several times around.
Combination twice or bing, 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 bing.
Stop trying to ease your way up there. This guy's so tired he can't hold up his hands, and you're easing your way up there.
Okay.
That's not necessary.
Okay.
Get them, I mean, hey, get some boogie up. Okay. I mean, put some hurt on this guy early. Let's go. Let's go.
Ding, ding, ding.
Round 10. Scheduled for 12.
Holy's own corner imploring him to load up. Bing, 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 they said. That's a power combination. They're looking for him to load. 2, 3, 4. Bang, bang, bang. Unload the big combinations and do it early.
Holyfield had Ruiz in deep trouble at the end of round 3. He couldn't put him away. There's Ruiz sticking and stuffing that left jab. And then he completely took off round 4, did Evander Holyfield.
And round 5.
He just couldn't finish Ruiz off. It looked as if there was something actually physically wrong with him. Or maybe his right hand. He was just holding back for some reason. But Don Turner, Holyfield's trainer, told our Jim Gray there's nothing wrong with Holyfield.
Well, in all honesty, I don't think Don would tell us if there was in the middle of a fight. I don't think he would risk that. Information might get out and help John Ruiz or do anything to hurt Holy.
Well, perhaps following the fight, we'll find out that there was something wrong.
John Ruiz slipped and he blocked a big hook, and then he looked like his legs came out. It didn't look good.
Yeah, all of a sudden, he looks a little out of it.
Let's go.
Oh, it was a low blow. And Ruiz now staggers to the Holyfield corner.
He hit him one side of the border. It was a pretty good shot.
The fans think Ruiz is faking. And if he is, he's a heck of an actor. Fans don't like it.
Okay. Okay.
The fighter is hit below the belt and can't continue in 5 minutes. He loses.
You ready? You ready to continue?
Richard Steele asks him if he's ready to go.
Let's go.
Well, Ruiz on shaky ground now after being hit below the belt.
If Holyfield doesn't jump on him now, Steve, you know something's wrong, regardless of what Don Turner says.
I agree. And let's see what Ruiz has in him. Ruiz is the aggressor. But there's a big left hook by Holyfield, followed by a right hand and another left hook. But back comes Ruiz. And now Holyfield sticking the jab. Back comes Ruiz with the left jab.
Ruiz's jab will have won this fight if he does get the decision, if he doesn't get knocked out.
Don't hold him, don't hold him. Don't hold him, break, break, step back.
So it looks like Ruiz looking to weather another problem.
Oh, he feels his mouth is bleeding now too.
Get out.
Holyfield trying to score with that wicked right uppercut, but missing. Again, the right uppercut, but grazing. Combination to the head. Ruiz then playing a little possum, comes back.
He comes back, and both of these fighters right now are at a fatigue point, and the fatigue is becoming a factor.
Break, step back. Oh!
They'll both be happy to hear the bell.
Dave.
What?
20. All you gotta do is move on this guy. You gotta use your jab, buddy. Come on, kick in, kick in. Come on, champ.
Holyfield throws a real nice left hook here that appeared to be blocked by John Ruiz right here. Oh, and it wasn't. It was hit him on his head. You see, look at his right leg. His right leg does a little Leon Earl and gets rubbery. A low blow. Right underneath. Wasn't that low. Wasn't that low.
And you hear the fans reacting. They see it on the big screens.
After the low blow, Holyfield lands a nice left hook. That one appeared better than the last one, but
let's go, second.
John reacts well, fires back.
Into the championship rounds for the vacant WBA heavyweight title, round 11. Lennox Lewis chose not to face Ruiz previously, took Michael Grant instead, beat him easily. Some might say that was a wise decision after seeing
Great.
This.
Step back.
Ruiz seems to be in control of this fight.
The sense of urgency for Evander Holyfield should be at a maximum, should be at a premium. He should be letting it all hang out. He hasn't got but less than 6 minutes.
You just never know what the judges are thinking, and Ruiz told us he's going to have to win this fight, if not by knockout, by decisive decision. And that very well may be the case.
Seven rounds to five would be one thing, but eight or nine rounds to two or three rounds, or eight rounds to four would be, I think, clean enough.
Come on, work it, break. Step back. His hands are free, let's work.
Holyfield coming in. A close 4-1 favorite.
Some people thought the odds should have been much higher. It was John Ruiz, the only time he stepped up. We talked about David Tua. That goes one game. All that Holyfield's accomplished. 4-1 short.
And Holyfield knows from being an underdog. He was a 30-1 underdog as Ruiz lands an overhand right to the head of Holyfield.
Step back.
Evander, a 30-1 underdog before the first fight with Mike Tyson. And we all know what happened there.
There was a perfect example of John Ruiz's jab saving him defensively. He had it out there. Holy's right hand couldn't get around it, and it blocked the right hand.
Bobby, it's not that Ruiz has stunned or actually hurt Holyfield throughout the fight. It's just as if Holyfield has not really been in the fight for the most part.
He's consistently outworked him, like there. You see him work his way in, throw the combination. Holy waits for him, looks for one or two big ones. For whatever the reason, Steve, Holy just doesn't have it today.
One of your keys to victory for the quiet man, outwork Holyfield. And he has done just that throughout. He has out-hustled the former champion.
Break, step back. Break, step back.
Holyfield looks shocked. He's desperate.
Pull your arm back. Pull it back. Your hands are free.
Moving very slowly, very deliberately now. He's going to have to rely on a dramatic finish.
It will have to be one of the most dramatic finishes in history.
I'm rolling.
And he's never had a 12th round knockout.
Break, step back. Hold it.
Break, step back. Got one round to do it, buddy.
Holyfield's daughter. Very concerned.
Twelfth round coming up.
3 minutes. Three minutes.
Last and final round.
3 minutes.
You're gonna go with everything for 3 minutes, Evander.
You gotta get on the body.
With everything.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Every time you go to the body, you hurt him. He cries like a baby to the referee. You gotta fight.
Evander.
Just keep your left hand up and your head moving on the way up. All he's got is that right hand. That's it.
And he ain't got that one. Stop trying to counterpunch him.
Come on, look at me.
Come on.
You out?
Huh?
Come on, Johnny, last round. Nothing stupid, box. You can't kill this guy.
This is round 12.
They were all giving advice to Holyfield, Ken Weldon, Don Turner, and Tim Hallmark. Let's see if it pays off. The Quiet Man's fans back in Chelsea, Massachusetts, must be making a lot of noise tonight.
Don Turner said something very smart. Stop trying to counter him, because that means you got to wait for John to lead. You You got to lead. You got to take the play away. You got to deliver and land first.
12th and final round for the vacant WBA heavyweight championship. They're going to have to stop it again because of the loose tape.
Let's go, you guys. Real good, real good.
The third or fourth time it's happened. As mentioned, Holyfield has never had a 12th round knockout in his professional career. It looks like he's going to need one tonight to win this fight.
You know, many years ago, John Tate fighting Mike Weaver. John Tate dominating the fight. He got knocked out in the last round with just a minute or so to go.
Time.
John Ruiz 1-1 when the fight has gone the full 12 rounds, losing to Donnell Nicholson in 94, a win over Jimmy Thunder in 97.
I saw the Nicholson fight. I thought Ruiz won. I thought he was robbed. But that's the way it goes sometimes. The judge's eyes or the judge's decisions are final.
Ruiz looking very sharp here. A lot of movement. And he finally throws. Holyfield not doing anything. And he needs to desperately. What is he waiting for? Being pushed back by that effective Ruiz jab.
There's 2 minutes left. And Hoy has not made the most of that first minute.
Win or lose, Holyfield said earlier here, he will not retire after this fight.
I think a bare minimum of what he'll need to do after this is come back just to prove that this was another fluke.
Let's go.
And that could be a mistake and very detrimental to his health. A lot of people are calling for his retirement right now, even before this fight.
I wish he looked like this when I fought him, Steve.
Good luck. Halfway through the final round.
Watch your elbow.
Don Ruiz may be a minute 20 and counting away from being a heavyweight champion.
Oh, he's trying. You can see him swinging hard and trying. John Ruiz just trying to put his head down and get out of harm's way. A little over a minute left.
How many people outside Chelsea Mass? Nope. Is he calling it a knockdown?
No.
He waved it off. But there's blood on the face of Ruiz.
Ruiz is exhausted. All he needs to use is that jab. Stuff that jab. Step with it. There he goes. Step with the jab. But he is so tired, Steve. I know how it feels.
All Ruiz has to do is stay away. And he's got it. Holyfield coming forward, stalking the bloodied Ruiz.
I'm holding. Watch him.
Holyfield getting dirty.
Give him a little elbow for him right in the nose.
Ruiz hanging tough against the onslaught of Holyfield. 25 seconds.
Go home.
What a sense of urgency for Holyfield.
Keep your head.
He's got to put Ruiz away.
Right.
Seemingly to win the fight.
Let him go. Let him go, Ruiz.
Holyfield won the last round, Steve, but that's it.
It is all over.
Bam.
People outside Chelsea, Massachusetts, and perhaps Puerto Rico would have thought that John Ruiz would hold the world heavyweight title. It may happen. It should happen.
Steve, we talked about the catch-22. If Ruiz beats Holyfield, I don't think any fighter here, either of these fighters, up their stock tonight.
You should be ashamed of yourself.
Good show, Johnny. Good show.
You should be ashamed of yourself. You should be ashamed of yourself.
Johnny, great job, man.
You should be ashamed of yourself. You didn't give him any warning. Look at the thing. You should be ashamed of yourself.
Norm Stone really giving it to Richard Steele.
It's about the elbows and the forearms. Always slammed a few in here. One of them started John's nose bleeding.
Tell me what you do. And tell me exactly how it would end up.
Yeah, thank you, man.
That's exactly what they said. You do that. Exactly. Fucking kick right your time off. You can't take a point away. You're scared.
Norm Stone complaining to referee Richard Steele for not taking a point away for the roughhouse tactics by Evander Holyfield. He's fuming at Steele. And Steele, a guy who's known to do that. We've seen that many times. We've seen him disqualify guys for doing that kind of stuff. But he's not about to do it in this kind of fight.
That's
So we await the decision.
You think that last?
It's in the hands of Fernando Viso, Venezuela, Dwayne Ford, Vegas, Dave Moretti,
no,
Las Vegas.
Stick up? Who's going to stick up? It could be a disgrace, though.
First down. Take a look at some of those roughhouse tactics that they were complaining about. When Hoey comes in, there's a little shove with the shoulder. That one might have been low, I don't know. But nothing really bad there. Here's a little extra in slow motion. Oh, by the way, take this elbow in your face with you. Yeah, a little chicken wing in the face. That was blatant. That was very blatant.
Ruiz complaining to Richard Steele. Jimmy Lennon Jr., our ring announcer, is ready with the scores.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing here in Paris, Las Vegas, we go to the scorecards. We have a unanimous decision. Here are the score totals. Judge at ringside, Fernando Viso scores the bout 116 to 112. Judges Dwayne Ford and Dave Moretti both score the bout 114 to 113, all three in favor of the winner. And now the four-time heavyweight champion of the world, Evander, the real deal, Holyfield.
Incredulous, absurd, ridiculous.
Steve, I always talk about agendas. No better a picture can be painted for an agenda than Evander Holyfield, Mike Tyson, for the trilogy to be completed.
Ain't nobody can stop his
name. That was ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous.
What a stinker of a decision.